Well, I'm in Saskatchewan on the prairies, and I'm near the west side, near the west border of Saskatchewan, going into Alberta. And besides all the dead trees and everything I've been seeing, I see something else. There's all these ponds of water here, all along this stretch of highway, quite a ways, quite a few miles, and there's something really bizarre going on. All along the shore, all around the edges, it's all white. So I'm going to stop the video and I'm going to walk over there and I'm going to zoom in and show you. You tell me what this white stuff is that's on the water, on the edge of the water. And some people it might say, oh, it's red, it's runoff from the farmers. Well, even so, it's not right and it's not natural. But anyway, I'm going to go look at it, and maybe somebody out there can leave a comment and tell me what they think this is. So you can go to Folk Photographer on YouTube to see all the videos about this. And here I go. I'm going to turn the camera off now. Trees there, they look really sick. Color's really bad. The grass in this area is all like this colored. I'm gonna go closer. This stuff smells like propane. Too close. That's a fence post. Like another environmental disaster. It's not natural. Definitely smells like gas, propane gas. There's a whole big long waterway here, and it's got this stuff all over it. You'd think environmental people would be here checking this out, finding out what this is. See, I'm zoomed in so you can see how big this is. And this goes all the way over to the other side of the highway. You can tell, if it was natural, the shit wouldn't be on top of these plants. It got on top of the plants and then the plants died. This happened pretty recently. So, unfortunately, we don't have governments anymore because they don't speak any truth and don't tell us about anything. And if the people don't know what's going on and the voice of the people doesn't matter, then we're losing everything that's important to this planet. Because the good people have to be heard, and the bad people control everything, and they don't want to hear us. Now, we're so far inland around here, there's no lakes, there's no major waterways here. Who knows where this shit came from? If I wasn't shaking so much, it would stay focused. You try holding a really powerful pair of binoculars and see what happens when you're zoomed in. The tiniest little movement looks like you're shaking. So, welcome to the new world. And right now they're having a huge fire in Alberta, tar sands. I'm only hearing what people are saying, but they're saying it's really, really bad. 288,000 hectares of forest and whatever else is burning, probably all their chemicals. You know, this would be a pleasant trip across Canada if I didn't see all the devastation everywhere. And the reason why I notice it is because I do photography. That's why I call myself the visionary folk photographer. Because visionary means I see the visions of what's happening. And I present the visions of it as photographs and videos to you. Ah, well. Thank you for watching. Go to chemtrailsinourskies.wordpress.com. Go to the Fukushima radiation tree reports.wordpress.com and get involved and speak up. When you see the chemtrails, you have to wake up, look up, you have to speak up. Here's some more of that white stuff on the side of the highway on the in the grass. And I have it here.